The deep sea is a hidden world of wonder. As we have explored so far in this series, it is home to countless ecosystems of abundant biodiversity, though veiled beneath the inky waters of the deep. But there is one location in the deep sea that poses an even greater mystery. Hidden away beneath the sea ice of the Arctic and the Antarctic lies a lost world of giants. Creatures that have adapted in remarkable ways to a life in these icy, sunless waters, forming vast communities that we are only just beginning to explore. Let's take a closer look at what's been found lurking in the dark beneath the ice. Life at the poles can be incredibly difficult. Long, cold winters bring bitter winds that whip across the landscape. Temperatures plummet deep into the negatives as the winter night falls, bringing darkness that can last for months. Sea ice reaches far beyond the shores of any frozen landmass, a constant though seasonal feature of polar marine ecosystems, the importance of which cannot be understated. Sea ice maintains the low temperatures of polar regions and helps to moderate the global climate. Its bright surface reflects the sunlight that strikes it back into space. Without this vast expanse of white, the dark ocean would absorb this light and heat up, throwing ecosystems around the world into chaos. Sea ice is important also for many of the surface-dwelling creatures of polar regions. For these seemingly barren landscapes host a rich diversity of wildlife, both above and below the ice. In the Arctic, ice is an essential hunting ground for polar bears. These lone hunters are totally dependent on it, prowling the icy plain in search of breathing holes where their seal prey come up to the surface. In the Antarctic, the ice platform is equally important for seals and penguins, relying on sturdy ground where they can breed and raise their young. However, sea ice is also home to a diverse community of microorganisms and invertebrates, creatures whose populations support the entirety of both polar food webs. The underside of sea ice is not as smooth as the surface. Here, it is riddled with channels and cavities that create an uneven surface. Formed when pockets of salty brine trapped between the ice crystals drain away and form channels, this is the perfect habitat for microorganisms, photosynthesizing algae and bacteria, waiting patiently to bloom in spring in a mighty oceanic feast. Some channels are large enough to provide a refuge for larger creatures. Amphipods, krill, and tiny worms, clinging to the safety of these ice formations. They utilize them as a sort of upside-down seabed. In the Southern Ocean, krill feed on the phytoplankton and graze on the sea ice algae. Because of the plentiful food found under the ice, krill are known as a keystone species, underlying the entire food web of the Southern Ocean. In the Arctic Ocean, a community of creatures thrives in a world without sunlight. From carnivorous sea stars to floating ctenophores, life persists in perpetual conflict. there is no marine snow directly beneath the ice sheets. For all that lies above is a thick layer blocking out the sun. As a result, most animals are predatory. Even the most innocent-looking, the graceful sea angel, feasts solely on its relative, the sea butterfly. Around Antarctica, there are a number of hidden ocean cavities that play important roles in the circulation of currents, nutrients, and creatures. At 480,000 square kilometers, the Ross Ice Shelf is the largest floating slab of ice on Earth. And it conceals an ocean cavity that extends 700 kilometers south of Antarctica's coast and remains largely unexplored. But recently, the Antarctic deep has become the focus of a number of expeditions in search of what life could possibly survive down there. It was believed by many that in the depths beneath the ice, you would find nothing more than a biological dead zone. The deep ocean around Antarctica is a unique place. The weight of the ice sheets has pushed down the submerged continental shelf to be deeper than most places. Usually, the continental shelf is found between 100 and 200 meters down. But here, we must sink to 600 meters before the edge looms out of the darkness and a gaping void opens up beneath. This is a gateway to the deep, not only for researchers, but for marine life. The water temperature near the surface is not too different from the cold depths, meaning deep sea creatures are able to come into much shallower waters than usual. As such, a world of wonders lies in wait. Communities of creatures that are often out of reach of submersibles in other parts of the world. Oxygen-rich waters supply a plethora of life. This is made possible by the freezing of Antarctic seawater in winter, which leaves behind extremely cold, salty water. This water sinks and flows, providing the life-giving oxygen to deep waters all around the world, preventing the deep sea from becoming a dead zone due to hypoxia. But here is it most concentrated. The most oxygen-rich waters on the planet, concealed beneath a barren world of ice. Creatures make the most of this phenomenon. Gigantic sea spiders tread across the sea floor, with leg spans of up to 40 centimeters. The lack of a respiratory system means that in most parts of the world, sea spiders grow no larger than a few millimeters across. Here, in the oxygen-rich conditions, they can grow far larger, exhibiting the phenomenon of polar gigantism. Marine invertebrates that occur at the poles tend to have much larger body sizes than their relatives that live elsewhere. It can be seen in many of the creatures here. 2-meter-tall giant sponges cling to drop stones. Large boulders that fall from passing icebergs, providing islands of rocky habitat on the soft mud for filter feeders to cling to. Thanks to them, feather stars and cold water corals have colonized the region, feeding on the abundant marine snow that accumulates here. Well adapted to a stable and unchanging environment, these plant-like animals grow very slowly, but to enormous sizes. Very few fish are found here. Unlike in most marine ecosystems where they dominate the food web, they struggle to survive the freezing temperatures here. Instead, the Antarctic deep is a prehistoric world, dominated by giant invertebrates, like the Antarctic sun star, which captures passing krill with tiny pincers. The few fish that do live here must find creative ways to adapt. One, known as the ice dragonfish, has antifreeze proteins in its blood to stop it from freezing into ice. Creatures here belong to a community that has been isolated from the rest of the planet for millions of years. The powerful Antarctic circumpolar current swirls around the frozen continent, creating a steep temperature gradient that stops marine animals from spreading. Their isolation has led to the diversity we see today. Creatures unique to the region that have evolved to live on the sea floor. The deep sea found beneath the poles is a world of hidden wonders. Organisms unlike any that are found elsewhere, owing to their isolation in an oxygen-rich pocket of life. A stable and undisturbed cradle, yet one that is now threatened by human activity. The warming of the climate could disturb these ancient ecosystems, allowing invasive species to wander further south or north than they would normally be able to. The equilibrium of life in the polar deep faces an uncertain future. We risk losing one of the ocean's best-kept secrets before we even understand its importance. To find out more about the deep sea and to visualize just how deep some of these creatures live, visit the Exploring the Zones page over on our Deep Sea Hub, where you can scroll down through a scale model of our oceans.